Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have been truly blessed. For this Friday, July 12th, we are getting the death of Slim Shady Coup de Grace, Eminem's 12th studio album and the third installment of the Slim Shady series. 1997, we had Slim Shady EP. 1999, we had the Slim Shady LP. 2024, the death of Slim Shady. I was like, there's no way. It has been 4 years since the GOAT himself has dropped an album. And I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to sit here and bullshit you. I was beginning to lose a little bit of hope, all right, until March 21st of this year. If you don't know what's been going on, I'm going to catch up to speed. I'm your guy. Let's check it out. Okay, so Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, and 50 Cent were on the Jimmy Kimmel Talk Show. Dre made probably the biggest announcement of this year. I'm not going to lie to you.
What up? This is Dr. Dre.
That's my best Dre. Dre confirmed that his protege, Eminem, will be releasing his 12th record. Yo, what up?
This is Dr. Dre.
Eminem's working on his own album, which is coming out this year. Crazy. Yo, what up?
This is Dr. Dre.
And at this point, I was like, okay, we got an album announcement, but, you know, it's been a little while. Where's, like, a teaser? Do we get, you know? So, I'm excited, but my patience was growing thin. Until April 25th, we have the name of the album and a trailer, nonetheless. The Death of Slim Shady Coup de Grace. I was like, no way. We're getting Slim Shady. This is like a big deal. Look, check it out. Check this out.
Through his complex and oft-criticized tongue-twisting rhymes, the blonde anti-hero known as has had no shortage of enemies. Perhaps it's no surprise that the same rude lyrics and controversial antics which made him infamous may have ultimately led to his demise.
So who killed Slim Shady?
With such a wide field of potential suspects, join me as we recreate the events that led to his slaying in the hopes that someone, somewhere, will come forward with the truth.
All right, so at this point, I'm like, okay, not bad. I'm stoked. I'm hyped. The album announcement is kind of settling in. You gotta let it sizzle. He's doing little side quests. He had the NFL draft that took place in Detroit, so it was a big deal.
Let's go!
Not only that, but he had his daughter's wedding. But congratulations to her and Mr. Eminem himself. Very special moment. My love and condolences to... I don't even know them, though. You know? Yeah, I've been sitting here for a minute thinking about that. Like, okay. Anyways, while that's happening, while little, you know, little things are happening, big things, little things are happening, whatever. Another announcement comes afloat May 30th. The announcement of Houdini, a single, a song that's going to be on the Death of Slim Shady. Now, if you haven't heard that song, go check that out. Go check out the music video. Dude, if you haven't heard Houdini, dude, you suck, you idiot. He did a performance in Detroit with Jelly Roll. And then he performs Welcome to Detroit with Trick Trick for the first time ever. My bad. Almost forgot to introduce yourself. My name is Trick Trick. Dude, this is crazy, you know, like, this is like the most I've heard from Eminem in, like, so long. So as Houdini is topping charts, getting number one, making history, no surprise there, I'm not shocked. Look at me. Not shocked. We get Baby Tron, Big Sean, and Eminem for the single Toby. Toby is another song that's going to be featured on the album. Gonna be honest, though, this is where, like, I kind of... It's all right. Toby was all right. I'm not going to sit here and glaze everything that Eminem has done. Come on. It's weird, though, because the more I listen to Toby, the more it grows on me. So, yeah, that's pretty recent. That's like, it's like July. Dude, my fucking mic died. All right, well, that's why the audio sounds different. My mic died. Anyways, that's just me, though. I don't know. I don't know how you guys feel about it. Let me know. So now we are in current day than a day ago. The album artwork of the Death of Slim Shady Coup de Grace comes out. What do you guys think? I think it's cool because it's simple. I feel like it's a lot. This album is going to be a lot to live up to. I don't know. I think it's going to be... The expectations are high. I'm trying to keep them as low as I can, but dude, It's hard. It's hard. Oh, yeah. Skylar Grey is going to be on the album, too. You guys have definitely heard of Skylar Grey, the chorus for I Need a Doctor. She wrote the chorus for Walk on Water. Beyonce ended up singing it. And then that song she has with Eminem called Come On, Let Me Ride. You got to check that one out, too. That one's pretty cool. Boom. Here's the track list. Dude, that's what they're saying, too, that the album is going to be an hour and 4 minutes, I think, long. We got three skits on the album. One of my predictions is that Ken Kniff will definitely be on a skit.
At the tone, please say your name.
Kenneth Kniff from Connecticut.
Guess who's back? Back again. Ken is back. Tell some men. Yeah, I got something to share.
Come back. Why does everyone always leave me?
Ken Kniff is coming out. Mark my words. Because I will be reacting to the album. I'm stoked. So you're caught up to speed with everything I know, at least. Go hear it. Let me know what you think. Come back to the video. Comment. Shady's back. But he's dead, you know? Like, you know everything that you need to know. It's time, baby. It's time. That's all I gotta say. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys learned something. Hope you guys like my shirt. I'm gonna gatekeep where I got this shirt. I guess I'll see you guys when the album drops, dude. Peace.